Hi, my name is Greg Ren. I'm the Assistant Collections Manager for Birds and Mammals here at the Canadian Museum of Nature. And you guys are in for a treat. I'm gonna show you around the bird and mammal collections over here. And it's generally not open to the public. It's fairly tight for space and it's not conducive to having large groups of people, which is why it's not open. Our collection has about 127,000 lots of specimens, which includes 2,700 species, which are from all over the world. Most of our specimens are like this under the form of study skins, but we also have a number of taxidermied specimens, nests, and eggs. And so I'm just going to show you around some of the highlights of our collections. Here we have an assortment of birds which are naturalized. We have about 1,500 naturalized specimens here at the museum, and they're used primarily for exhibit purposes. They get sent off on loans, they're used for education, and they're also reference material for artists. We have sculptors, painters, sometimes photographers which will come in here. They want to get details absolutely perfect, so this is the ideal place to do their work. So right now we're heading off to the egg collection, which is hidden in the back right next to the turkey. So here at the Museum of Nature, we have a fairly sizable egg collection. It covers most Canadian species. We also have a bit of exotic stuff as well. Over here, we have some beautiful ptarmigan eggs. You might wonder why we have so many eggs of one species. Well, the truth is that it covers a broad geographic area, and also it covers a huge timeline. For example, we have eggs over here, which are from the Coronation Gulf on June 19th, 1911. So one of the primary goals for the collections is to have a proper coverage throughout time and space. We have a fairly big nest collection at the museum, and you might wonder why we have nests of all the various species throughout Canada. And it really does help as reference material in order to identify things in the field. Nests can be very variable depending on the species. We can have things as small as a hummingbird nest or as large as a raven. And even within a species, it can be very variable. So it's very important to have good reference material so that we can make precise identifications of the birds. So the majority of the bird collection is in the form of study skins, about 107,000 to be exact. Primary use of study skins is for researchers and students that are doing research projects. They can be used for anything from morphometrics to DNA or isotope work. So we've only had the opportunity to look within a couple of drawers in this room. Can you imagine how many more gems such as this purple-breasted Katinga are hidden behind me?